CNC equipment is great. It's reliable, reproducible, and can make complex geometries for you. Yet, when you set it up, you often need to have some sort of a manual operation. Just to touch some bit, make a test cut, dial to the right position, and so forth. Often you also want to have some sort of a feel how everything behaves, which is difficult to do. You can of course put buttons, press buttons on the computer, but it's not the same. In a manual machine, what you have, you put one hand on one axis, another hand on another axis, and you can feel and rotate the dials to make some cuts and while looking at what's going on. In the CNC, if you have to press buttons, you often have to look at the buttons and the bits, and it's very messy, very uncomfortable. In many standard CNC panels, you have a single dial and a lot of switches. Again, you make one movement, press some button, make another movement, press another button. It's very messy. It kills a lot of feel from this. So I made this simple panel, just a couple of rotary encoders, which cost a few dollars, and an Arduino, a microcontroller that can interface with USB and can be perceived by the computer as a standard USB keyboard. So Mark treats this pennant as a simple keyboard that it takes command for manual operations. We start with a 3D printed case you saw before. A little bit of light sanding, and you can see there are some dense indentations that will be painted. So I apply masking tape over the whole plastic body. The idea is to cut out the dense paint over everything, remove the masking tape. So I'm making cuts to put arrows and axis directions. And printing quality of this dents wasn't great, so that's what we have painted. And the tape is removed. You can see the dents are painted, but quality is only somewhat okay. Z and X turned out quite reasonable. After a touch of sanding, I'm putting in the encoders. They just held in place by friction and pressed against the back with the studs. The buttons are pressed. Six buttons. They have no functions at the moment. That's the schematic I have. You can see it's very simple. I have Arduino, micro, whatever. What's crucial that it's based on 32U4. Chip, it might be Leonardo. The idea is that each chip has native USB support and it can be used, it can emulate the behavior of a keyboard or a mouse. The only requirement. We have a USB socket that is connected directly through micro USB to Arduino. We have Arduino connected to ground and a lot of buttons, array of left, right buttons. And they are just connected to ground on one side and the other side Arduino pins. The idea is we ask Arduino a certain pin, say 12. It's internally inside Arduino, it's pulled up, and the button when it's pressed, a signal goes from high to low momentarily. And this is, we have only single wire to pin, all common ground, and we have two encoders, X and Z encoders. The buttons of the encoder are connected the same way, pull up and buttons 5 and 4. And we have also the actual encoder bits, ground and two pins 6 and 7. It's a bit better to have hardwire interrupt pins, but we are not talking about time critical applications here, so good enough. These are the buttons soldered together. You can see common ground and brightly colored strips that go to the Arduino pins. The standard USB socket bead to micro is just screwed. Now we are soldering all these connectors together, the common ground and the background, and we are just connecting all the encoder and buttons to this Arduino Pro Micro. The holes in the box are tapped M3, just in PLA. It's not the strongest ever, but it will do the job. Stresses are quite negligible. You can see everything is packed and spaced behind the encoders in free, so they can be pressed. Now the body is just screwed together, so it's held as a single unit. And here it is. The encoders click. We can put the buttons. They spin. They click. Let's have a look what we have now. The code of the Arduino firmware is very simple. You can see there is a lot of definition, but everything is basic. We have two pins for the encoder, and we have three buttons, auxiliary buttons, three on the left, three on the right. We have definitions of the key presses. So once the current firmware uses only X and Z keys, so we have X up, X down, Z up, Z down, and these are just standard arrow buttons. You can ask the rotary buttons to switch either jog mode or cycle in Mach 3, so it presses something like Ctrl J and Alt J by default. We are using the existing libraries, freely available, the link below for the encoder. Just define two encoders. We use the keyboard library from Arduino to simulate keyboard presses. We have one button library to deal with the buttons. And in the setup, that's something crucial. For each of the button press, and each button is defined here, button X has a certain pin number, and true it means pull up. So once we click, single click, we attach the function, it will execute this function, in this case send stop, and it sends this send stop function, sends these 2-to-1 asterisks. What you can see here is mainly processing of the rotary encoder, and it works well enough for me. Now I'm facing the part which was faced a bit before and show why the pennant is good. So you can see I have two hands on the wheels, and while looking exclusively onto the piece, I can do very, very small 80 micron steps. It is a bit awkward to keep spinning that wheel, but on a manual way, that's what you can do. And the beauty, of course, here that you can change the step length, so you can do it as small or as big as you wish, of course up to a limit. This is a small rod of acetal. I would like just to feel how it machines and how it is chemically and physically, to understand if it's suitable for my purpose. And once I establish the start, I can put 0Z. Almost for sure X here is correct because I used it before. But now I can make cut in Z direction. This means moving this way. So I can measure the diameter I got. Mach 3 is set in the diameter mode, so I can now measure the diameter I have got. A little spin pass. And make sure that X-axis is calibrated well.